close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left.
What is up, guys? It is Saturday morning and I need to go grocery shopping, so we're here at Kroger and I got Grant with me. We're gonna take the camera in and we're gonna just do a little shopping trip, show you guys kind of what I'm buying right now. All my diets help me, you know, stick to my goals, get leaner, all that good stuff. So you guys ready? Let's go. All right, next up, guys, I wasn't a huge fan of berries or really fruit in my diet before, but now that I'm trying to get my nutrition from clean sources, this has been a focus for me, and I will tell you guys, since I switched to this, I've never felt better in my life. So I wasn't a big berry guy, but lately I've been eating about one container of raspberries or one container of blackberries a day. I'm telling you, this has been, oh, this is leaking. Look at that. So make sure they're not leaking, but it's been a huge game changer. Micronutrients, fiber, and you get a lot of volume there for very little calories and very minimal carbohydrates. So probably gonna pick up, we'll do a couple raspberries and we'll get a blueberry too. Strawberries, everything else works. So pick up some of these. Now, another thing I've been doing with my carbohydrate sources is a lot of potatoes. So we got red potatoes here. I've been doing a ton of these. I think they are extremely tasty, in my opinion, when I'm meal prepping them. They're pretty inexpensive. I think this bag is $2.99 for all these potatoes. So tons of carbohydrates here. And I also do white potatoes from time to time. I have some of those at the house. And then sweet potatoes, but I did sweet potatoes for so long, I kind of got bored of them. And I've been using just, like I said, red potatoes, and I don't really notice any difference. So bag of these too. So one of the staples in my diet that I usually have is peanut butter or almond butter or peanut butter powder. So I'm gonna pick up some of this stuff right here. I've been using this quite a bit in my oatmeal. It has a lot of the same flavor and stuff as peanut butter without all the fat and calories. So this is really good if you're dieting. So I'm probably gonna do another one of these containers. I try to avoid the chocolate ones. Like PB2 has chocolate and so does PB Fit, but they have more sugar in them. So we're trying to keep this as natural and clean as we can. We're gonna do some Barney butter, almond butter crunchy too. So good stuff here. It's always nice to look at the ingredients on the back and all you see is blanched roasted almonds, organic cane sugar, palm fruit, oil, and sea salt. So only four ingredients, so we know it's pretty it's about as close to the natural as we're gonna get. So I think that covers it for this aisle. Now, as far as vegetables go, right, you can buy your produce like this. I personally don't. I'm gonna get a shower. I personally don't, simply because I don't like anything I buy going bad. I don't like have to feel like I have to cook something in order for it not to expire. So I buy my vegetables frozen. I will show you guys that here in a little bit. This is totally fine. If this is how you wanna do it, you might save a little bit of money, but I prefer the convenience factor of microwave steam bags. I think it's way easier. And then I always like to get, okay, maybe not that one, because it's starting to go bad, but fresh bagged spinach. Now, I do buy frozen spinach that I'll make from time to time, but having these fresh bags around for salads and things like that, this is about the only vegetable I buy fresh. Maybe sometimes like pico de gallo or mushrooms, something like that, but these really aren't bad. $1.79 for this entire bag. And if you're dieting and you're really hungry, spinach not only is extremely nutritious, full of fiber, tons of micronutrients, you can dump this entire bag in a big bowl, throw some almonds on there, throw some chicken in there, have make yourself a salad, and it's just super volumizing. A lot of the advice I give when it comes to dieting is like finding stuff like this that's very voluminous, that fills you up and makes you feel like you're eating a lot more than you actually are calorie-wise. Because that's the thing, you got like one Big Mac is like 1,200 calories, but if you look at 1,200 calories in my clean diet, it is so much more food, right? So food for thought right there. Gonna get some of these. Now, one of the most convenient foods that you can find if you are low on protein is canned tuna. I eat canned tuna not all the time, but like if I'm in a hurry and I need 50 grams of protein, I don't wanna cook anything up, two cans of tuna is about perfect. And at 69 cents a can, 79 cents a can, you really can't go wrong with it. If you don't like tuna, you think it's a little fishy, they also have these tuna creations here, right? Like honey barbecue flavor. They're actually flavored packets. You can take a couple of these with you, open them up, put them in a meal prep container, eat them right there in a bowl. Telling you, these actually taste really good. Now, they're not as healthy for you as per se regular tuna, but it's not off by much. You might have like a gram of fat extra in this and a few grams of sugar, but still the better alternative than pizza. So we're gonna go ahead and get four cans of tuna. Now, as far as sauces go, right? Sriracha, ooh, used to be one of my favorite sauces, right? But there's a gram of sugar per serving in this. So if you're not careful, there's 158 servings in this entire thing. So think about it, if you use that much of it, you're talking 30 grams of sugar or something like that. So be careful with what you're putting in your body as far as sauces go. If you're trying to count calories, you're trying to watch macronutrient intake, a lot of this stuff has macronutrients in it. I'm a hot sauce slash mustard guy because there's no calories or usually any fat or anything like that in it. And if I'm gonna do this, I opt for this chili garlic paste instead by the same company. Tastes really good, and in my opinion, you know, I'd rather not have the calories and not have to worry about it. So anyways, we'll get one of these. Okay guys, we're also gonna go ahead and get some quinoa, a really nice grain here, lots of fiber, lots of protein, and it gives a nice variation for when I'm not doing like just potatoes and rice all the time. And then probably gonna do a bag of, I don't need that much of it, just some standard white rice. You can do brown if you want the extra fiber and micronutrients, but personally for me, I would rather my food taste better, in my opinion. I prefer white rice, so that's what I go with. I'm eating my veggies, I'm getting all my micronutrients in, so I'm not too worried about that fiber, so get these. Now, an awesome sauce with not many calories that a lot of people don't think about is salsa. Not only is it healthy for you, because it has micronutrients in it, you're helping get your vegetable intake up, but it's pretty expensive. $1.39 for this, and looking at a 31-gram serving is only 3 grams of carbs, and you get a gram of fiber in that, so 2 grams of natural sugar, so not too bad. Probably do 2 of these as well. Help give that bland chicken a little bit extra flavor. As far as cooking oils go, guys, I am a big proponent of coconut oil. I've been using this now for the last couple years, and personally, I love the flavor. There's a lot of health benefits for it. The jury's out lately. People are saying it's not as healthy for you as people were thinking it was for a while, but I don't know. It's worked for me. I think it's amazing, and I don't know. That's just my 2 cents. So if you don't want to trust this, then extra virgin olive oil is great too. If you're gonna buy this though, make sure right here we have virgin coconut oil, and it's unrefined and cold pressed, which is how you want to buy it, because that means it's been the least amount tampered with by the manufacturers and things like that, the least amount of processing. So you're getting as much nutrition in this as you possibly can. So go ahead and grab this. Now, as far as sauces go, one of my favorites is jalapeno mustard. That might not sound very good, but I'm telling you guys, this is amazing. Adds a ton of flavor to stuff with 0 calories. So really good option. We're gonna do that. And we're also in the hot sauce aisle, so we'll move down this way. I've seen any hot sauces here I like. Okay, and then we have really any hot sauce you want can work as long as you look at it and you see that there's no calories, sugar, or anything like that in it. So I think as of right now, I like some of this organic sauce right here. We'll get one of these and, ooh, Cholula green pepper. Can't go wrong with these. Now when you're cooking and you're buying seasonings, right, I'm trying not to have my sodium go too high just because I feel like I hold water, it bloats me and adds a little bit of that roundness to my belly that I don't want. So I try to do the salt-free seasonings. Now you have like Mrs. Dash, man, that baby's crying. Mrs. Dash, which doesn't have any salt in it. It's a little more expensive. So I like to go for the off-brand version. Where are you at? There we go. Salt-free Zesty Blend Originals by Kroger. These are only $2.19 a piece, as opposed to $3.79. We're saving $1.50 per. I usually stock up on these. They have garlic flavors too. I'm not seeing right here, but these are a way better alternative than just throwing a ton of salt on your stuff and not really, or not throwing anything at all and not having any flavor. So like I said, salt-free seasonings, good to go. All right, guys, we had to move away from the coolers because it's a little loud. I don't want you guys' audio listening experience to be hindered in any way, shape, or form. So protein-wise, we got ourselves some standard chicken breasts. I'm telling you, these are a staple in my diet. Almost any bodybuilder, anybody trying to eat healthy, I bet you've seen them buy chicken breasts from time to time. One of the most versatile meats to prep, keeps for quite a while, and it's pretty expensive, $1.99 a pound. So lots of protein here. And then what I'll do, as far as red meat goes, I always like to buy some lean ground beef. So 96.4 lean ground beef here, or this is a bison strip sirloin steak. And usually I only eat red meat at breakfast, typically when I'm getting my fats in, but you know, it never knows. You can balance them out and you can make it fit your macros in other ways too if you would like. And then 99% lean ground turkey breast as well. I love this. Another pure protein source, no fat, super easy to fry up real quick, and we're good to go. This has been probably my number one protein I've been using lately for all my meal prep. So just convenience, guys, is key. If it helps you stay in your diet, then hey, that matters more than anything else, really. Also gonna grab some old-fashioned oatmeal. Now I know oatmeal turns some people off, but I'm telling you, one of the healthiest complex carbohydrate sources you can have. I'm eating about a cup a day right now, usually for breakfast as my first meal. I love oatmeal, guys. A little bit of cinnamon in there. You can throw some of your berries in there if you want to do that for some added flavor. I think it tastes really good. Personally, I've been doing, like I said, the peanut powder that we got earlier, or just natural peanut butter. I'll throw it in there. Makes it taste really good. And then if you don't like that, right, you can go over here and we have these lower sugar versions. Where is it out of just the maple? There we go. Maple and brown sugar, lower sugar instant oatmeal packets. There's barely any sugar in this, but it adds a ton of flavor. So if you think the plain oatmeal is kind of disgusting, these are really good. Just be careful though, because they're really good. I've literally opened the packets up and chewed on them raw. If you ever dieted hard, you know the struggle. But we're just gonna go with the regular oatmeal for now. We're gonna go ahead and pick up some honey as well. Way better alternative than just regular sugar. Adds a ton of flavor to things, and you're getting some instant carbohydrates that can really fuel you before a workout or something like that. So if I know I'm gonna go train, or I'm gonna have like, I need to be high energy and I wanna get my carbs in my system real quick, I'll make some oatmeal, throw this in with it, and we are good to go. Maybe add some berries in there, we get the best of every world. And then as far as peanut butter goes, we're right here, so if I go, I'll show you. I normally buy Jif Natural. I have so much of this at the house right now, I'm not gonna buy any right now, but this stuff is so good. Jif Natural is so good. If you don't like your natural peanut butter or almond butter to be like, have the oil separation at the top where you gotta stir it, you don't have to do that with Jif. They take care of that for you, so good stuff. Now, I always keep nuts at the house just because even though I have peanut butter and almond butter available, sometimes just kinda having the handful, I can kinda on the go eat it. I'm a big fan of having almonds or something along those lines, peanuts around, normally almonds. And you can buy completely plain almonds that haven't had anything done to them. That might be your better option, but to me, they're just not very good. So I always buy salted and roasted almonds, or if I'm feeling a little froggy, these wasabi and soy sauce almonds are some of the best almonds you'll ever have in your life. That might not sound very good, wasabi and soy, but I'm telling you guys, I can't keep these in the house because it's literally like candy, but we're gonna go ahead and do, yeah, some almonds. Also gonna grab some rice cakes as well. Not a lot of nutrition here, but a very low calorie food, can help fill you up, and a nice snack if you're on the go. Put some peanut butter, almond butter on this, you're in business. Even some honey. And then, if you are meal prepping, get yourself some meal prep containers. I don't know if Elsa and Anna have to be on there. Olaf, is that Olaf, is that his name? I don't know if they have to be on there. Oh, there we go, hold on, let's swap it out. There we go, the Star Wars one. But meal prep containers make it easy to travel and go. Store your food in them after you're done prepping it and put it in the freezer, fridge, whatever, grab it when you need it. That is the key to staying on your diet, guys, being prepared ahead of time. So I don't even need these, I'm just showing you guys that they're here at your grocery store. And if not, link in my description box. I have the exact meal prep containers I use personally. I buy off Amazon, you click that link and get yourself some. Stepping away from the coolers, that way you guys don't have to hear those loud things. But some frozen veggies, like I told you guys about earlier, we got some broccoli right here, frozen. Steam bag makes it super convenient. I am a huge fan of Brussels sprouts. Don't sleep on these guys, I'm telling you. Brussels sprouts are really good in my opinion. A very hearty, full vegetable, a good addition to any diet. And then I also like to pick up some of these as well. We have these stir fry starters here, right? It's basically a mixture of a bunch of different veggies, but I'll throw it in a skillet, fry these up, and then throw my proteins in with them and make some really nice stir fries with minimal calories. So like I said, guys, it's all about finding those volume foods that fill you up, help you get those good sources of nutrition in. And then we also have a three pepper and onion blend here as well that I'm gonna get. So awesome, I think that wraps up veggies. Normally in all my old diets, I would be buying like things like Greek yogurt or cottage cheese to help me get my protein in, quick on the go snacks. Those are totally fine, but right now with my current diet, I'm doing zero dairy. So these can't work, unfortunately, but I still think they're a great addition to any diet. But for me right now, we're seeing what happens with no dairy. So yeah, not getting any of these, but figured I just wanted to touch on that for you guys. We're also gonna go ahead and get some eggs too. Huge fan of eggs. I eat eggs almost every single day for breakfast. I do two eggs and then some egg whites. And I don't like to separate the yolks from the actual eggs. I just buy these liquid egg white containers by themselves and mix the two together, weigh them out, that way I know exactly what I'm getting. Plus, these are amazing if, like I said, you want a lot of protein. 50 grams of protein in this. You could literally just drink it. It might turn your stomach a little bit, but I'm telling you, you need to get it in. You gotta get it in. But these are super convenient, so always buy a ton of these. 90.93, huh? Perfect. Not a bad trip, guys, about $90. I will load all this stuff up, and then when I get back to the house, we will wrap this thing up. Got everything unpacked, guys, and we're getting ready to put it all away, so I figured we'll just go through a quick run-through real quick. In this trip, we ended up getting our protein sources. We had chicken, we had lean ground beef, we also got some lean ground turkey. We got some fruits in the form of some berries. I have tons of these already in my fridge, so I only bought a couple just to kind of give you guys an example. We bought ourselves some fresh spinach, and then we also got ourselves some of the frozen vegetables, make sure we're getting those micronutrients in. And then we got some potatoes, white rice, quinoa is here somewhere, there we go. We ended up with some egg whites, we had salsas here, we got sauces, we got almond butter, we got seasonings, and pretty much everything I need to hit my diet 100%. And that's the thing, I have other shopping videos on my channel if you wanna check those out, where I go over some of the foods that aren't necessarily as clean for you, if that's the word you wanna use, but they can help you get through a tough spot in a diet, and ones I've leaned on for a very long time. This is the first time in my life I've done a 100% natural whole foods diet like this, and I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I feel the best I've ever felt. From an energy standpoint, from a mindset clarity standpoint, my body is changing almost daily, so it's been a really a eye-opener for me. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video. I try to bring you guys a variety of content that not only help you guys out, but keeps the channel fresh, exciting, and new. So hopefully you enjoy this video. If you wanna see more grocery videos like this, comment below, because now that I have a camera guy, we can film more stuff like this. So you guys let me know down in the comment section if you enjoyed this. Hit that like button. Please, 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 helps me out more than you know. And as always, don't forget to smile, remain positive, and pay someone a compliment, because you never know whose day you could be making better. With that, I am out here. This has been a Remington James production, and I'll see you fine ladies and gentlemen at the next video. See you guys.